and Roll Custodian, tonight at 7:30, New York News.
The following is a special presentation of ABC Sports.
ABC Sports presents live in its 30th anniversary season, the Professional Bowlers Tour. Today from Peoria, it's the True Value Open. In our first game, Dave Arnold is seeking his first PBA title. His opponent is six-time champion Dave Ferraro. That winner will face memorable 300-game shooter Pete McCordick. Next up will be the defending champion Amleta Monacelli. And our tournament leader is Bruce Hamilton from Seattle. That's our outstanding field of finals for this afternoon's Professional Bowlers Tour telecast. The professional bowlers have returned to the River City of Peoria for one of their premier events, the $200,000 True Value Open. The city of Peoria rises gracefully from the banks of the Illinois River, a navigable river, first by the Peoria Indians in 1673 by French explorer Joliet, accompanied by Father Pierre Marquette. Hello again, I'm Chris Schenkel. Here in Peoria, the first European settlement took place in 1691. Thus, they are celebrating their tricentennial, 300 years of history. We at ABC are celebrating our 30th anniversary year of the Professional Bowlers Tour. My colleague has been a big part of that over the years. He's at Landmark Recreation Center right now. Let's join Nelson Burton Jr.
Thank you, Chris Schenkel. Peoria, Landmark Lanes and Recreation Center, one of the favorite spots on all the PBA Tour for the players. And the big reason is extra money. The players can make $200,000 if they can roll a perfect game in today's final round. And two of the players in the announce booth with me have done just that. The first man on my extreme left, Bob Benoit, rolled the 300 in the Quaker State in 1988. Bob, what were your reactions as you rolled that final ball?
Well, the first thing was to try to win the title. And then after that, it was just to try to make the best shot possible. And after the ball came off my hand there, that last shot, it would dream come true.
All right, one of the great moments in bowling, and another man sitting right next to me, Pete McCordick. You did it in 1987 in the AC Delco Classic. What were your thoughts as you stood there on the final shot?
I don't think I've ever been so nervous in my life. It hadn't been done in 13 years. I just, right here, I just wanted to get started right, get the push away and first step going, then just kept my eyes on the target and let the ball go.
Very well disciplined shot, one of the best shots I've ever seen under pressure. A $100,000 from True Value for on that shot. Now today, another question. You have a chance to win $200,000. Is that going to be your primary thought, or are you going out after the match game?
Well, I think mainly you're just bowling for the matches. One of the things that helped me shoot to 300 last time was it was a close match, and I really didn't even think about shooting the 300 game until about the 10th frame. So if the matches are close, you just keep going, and who knows.
All right, Peter, good luck. And today we'll see how the players are playing the championship pair. There's oil 36 feet down the lane, a little heavier concentration in the center. The last 24 feet are dry. I look for good scores, especially on the left-hand lane. Now here's the line the players are playing. Our tournament leader is playing around the third arrow out into the 1-3 pocket. Dave Ferraro is right down the second arrow. Pete McCordick is playing a line a little more conventional, starting in the center, a pretty good size hook around the first arrow into the 1-3. Chris, excellent scores and a lot of money available.
That's right, a total of $200,000 in this True Value Open. $40,000 the winner, $22,000 for second, $12,500, $10,000, and $7,500 for fifth. We're ready for the first match. The handshake, head-to-head, Dave Arnold of Mesa and Gilbert, Arizona, born in Los Angeles. He's a 28-year-old, tall and lanky, 6'3", and watch how easy and deliberate he is as he moves to the line. First shot, left lane. Leaving the bucket on the left lane. That's Dave Arnold going against Dave Ferraro.
Two little bit different players here, Chris. Arnold and Ferraro have the same type of release, but Arnold throws the ball much slower. He plays for a little more hook and a little more finish. He didn't get it on the left-hand lane there.
Last week he was 27th in Erie, Pennsylvania. Seventh telecast. Nice job marking with that spare. Now we're going to look at the 1998 Firestone Tournament of Champions winner. 32-year-old Dave Ferraro of Kingston, New York. Way to the left. Beautifully done. His 32nd television appearance.
Dave Ferraro, five-step delivery, upright style, medium backswing. Very accurate player. And look at the position of his hand right underneath the ball. One of the really outstanding players on the tour and a little bit underrated. But he's going to be here for a long time, and he's bowling as well as anybody I've seen all year in the championship round. Second frame.
And a high hit leaving the 3-6-10. He has an amazing record. He's won 4 and lost 14 in his last 16 television appearances, yet he won 2 titles, the Firestone and the 1991 Bud Light.
Drifts a little high, the 3-6-10, crossing.
All right. So back up now is Dave Arnold. 3 regional titles. Hit once that first big PBA national victory. Okay.
Very methodical player. Dave Arnold, 4-step delivery, pushes the ball away a little bit after the first step, shoulder high swing. Look at his position of his left arm, his shoulders, the knee bend, perpendicular to the foul line, high follow through, textbook style.
I like his pace, not in a hurry. He's left the 6-pin now on the left lane.
Speaking with the 5 players right before we began the championship round, they had a little concern with the left lane. They said it was hooking quite a bit more than the right-hand lane. As we've seen it in the early going of both players, they've been perfect on the right-hand lane. The left-hand lane, they've struggled.
And bowler from Arizona continues to mark. Dave Ferraro quickly back up. His wife Gloria and their 2 children, John David and Gabrielle, are watching back in Kingston, New York. Dave Ferraro, usually a steady tour performer, has been conspicuously absent this year, and here's why.
Well, on January 24th, my wife and I were blessed with a beautiful baby girl named Gabrielle. And I've been home when my wife's recuperating. And I plan to bowl the rest of the winter tour.
Well, I can see his wife recuperating, but I don't know what David was recuperating from.
You got to hold hands, Bo.
Changing diapers.
So now, as Arnold before him, it's the bucket on the left lane. We're at the True Value Open, Landmark Lanes.
Needs to get the ball between the 2 and 5, let the ball take out the 8. A shot we've seen, as you said, Chris, Arnold convert in the first frame. The same situation faces Ferraro in the 4th.
Dave's first match on television was 1980 in Garden City, Long Island. ABC's coverage of the professional bowlers will return. Lanes in Peoria, Illinois. It's our first match. Non-winner Dave Arnold of Gilbert, Arizona is going against a 6-time winner named Dave Ferraro of Kingston, New York. He had a spare working for him. Now cross over to a more troublesome left lane.
Well, the right-hand lane, all the players are hitting pretty well, and it's a little bit tighter, and they just need to get that ball around the second arrow, and it sets up. And so we'll see how Arnold's playing the left-hand lane, lane 37. He's standing here. He's going to drift a little bit to the left and try to get the ball between the second and third arrow. So he's coming this way, swing the ball wide. Nobody's struck on this lane yet. Let's see what kind of adjustment he makes.
All right.
Dave Arnold is his name. He and his wife, Caroline, are expecting their first child in July. And now to the dad, twice, Ferraro. Spera. Boy, seesaw, punch, counterpunch, these two in our first match.
Ferraro with a neat style. He's a little bit upright with a somewhat stiff leg, but he gets nice cushion, good pivot step, and a good loft out over the foul line. And he controls the lane a lot more with speed and loft than most players do. So you watch this position he has on the lane. He's going to be starting much farther to the left than Arnold. He'll be sliding in this area. He'll be trying right over the second arrow with a good loft on the ball.
And again on the left lane, the third, Bucket.
And he's a little bit surprised. His ball's skidding too far down the lane. We know that the oil is 36 feet on the lane, but he's hitting in a heavy concentration in the center. It slides a little bit too far. He's afraid to move outside because he thinks it'll hook too much, but if he converts his spare and Arnold would strike in the sixth, Ferraro would have to take a gamble.
Okay. Both our professionals here in the first game marking steadily. Now up on the approach of the right lane, 28-year-old Dave Arnold. All right. Dave Arnold explains the steps needed to go from a solid casher to a PBA champion.
Well, right now, my life is coming into order a little bit better. I just got married recently, and I have a baby on the way. I have a new house, sponsor. So everything's coming together, and I think it's heading in the right direction. And just go on from here.
In this match, he's heading in the right direction with that three-bagger. Leading by 20, can increase it to 30. Okay, a 30-pin lead by Dave Arnold of Gilbert, Arizona. We'll be back.
It's here.
Undefeated Michael Carbajal puts his world title on the line live. It's the Fruit of the Loom Professional Boxing Series next on ABC Sports.
Smaller men are always fun to watch in boxing, especially Michael Carbajal and Marcus Pacheco. Ferraro.
He needed that because his opponent was getting out in front. Okay, Bo.
Thank you, Chris. Pete McCordick, 2 years since you've been in the championship round. Are you a little nervous before you go out there?
Well, I always get a little bit nervous whenever I bowl on TV. But I feel pretty confident. I had a decent reaction, so I'm just going to just try and have fun.
He knows how to throw strikes, Chris, and he's in the next match. Back to you.
Mm-hmm. Hoping to double. He'd gotten a 7-2. He'd have cut the lead to 20. Arnold's lead. Dave Ferraro. Best year was in 1988. Six telecasts. He won twice, both in Ohio and Columbus and North Olmsted. Terrific athlete. Comes from a long-time bowling family in New York State.
The full grip for Dave Arnold just puts his fingers in down to the first knuckle, buries his thumb. Very important. Most amateurs don't put their thumb far enough in the ball. Now he's trying to extend his lead to 40.
Okay, the young man that was fifth at the Greater Hartford Open in 1989 and fourth again in 1990, so he's been close. You know, next Saturday, ABC's Pro Bowlers Tour returns to the site of the most bizarre ending in our 31 years of broadcasting the tour. Pete Weber defends his title, won on a 10th frame Del Ballard channel ball. It's $150,000 Fairlanes Open, and cringing off to my right, our scorekeeper today, Del Ballard, live at 3 Eastern and Pacific, 2 Central. So we'll have a 2 sleeper 8 coming up on the left lane? A little of everything over there today.
They've had some tough spares on the left-hand lane, the 2-8. They've had the 2-4, 5-8 twice. Just needs to get the ball in the area of the 2-pin, let it carry out the 8. If he converts here, he has a potential 248. The Ferraro still has room for 220. But if Arnold would miss, Ferraro can still win.
All right. We're at Landmark Recreation Center. There are 50 bowling lanes in addition to theaters, restaurants, a little of everything. Maybe the best facility in America all around. Nice strike by Ferraro. This also is a 1992 site of the Illinois State Women's Bowling Championship. Between now and May, 23,000 women bowlers will cross these lanes here at Landmark, and they will leave $6 million helping the economy here in Peoria.
That's if they don't go on the riverboat, Chris.
Tough break.
Well, Dave Ferraro, his undoing was lane 37 in this 50-lane establishment. He struck every time on the right-hand lane 38. Never could get untracked on 37. He's going to be in the 180s. Finishes with 186, Chris. Dave Arnold, possible 248.
And knowing Dave Ferraro, the great competitor, he's steaming. He does not like it. But he's not on top. 186 for Ferraro. So you're beginning to see the smoothie Dave Arnold in the next match with McCordick. ABC Sports presentation of the Professional Bowlers Tour will return after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Pro Bowlers Tour, brought to you by True Value. Got a tough job to do? You can do it with True Value Hardware Stores. By Bud Light, everything else is just a light. And by Scope, the best thing, first thing in the morning.
Young bowler Dave Arnold, looking for his first PBA title, has just defeated Dave Ferraro, 248, 186, 9 strikes. Let's go down to Nelson Burton.
Thank you, Chris. Dave Ferraro, you were my pick to win the tournament today. I thought you bowled as well as anybody all week long and just struggled, especially on the left-hand lane.
Yeah, I thought True Value was paying $100,000 to shoot a Dutch 200, but actually in practice I had the left lane a lot better than the right lane, and when we started it reversed on me, so just never figured out the left lane.
He's an awfully tough player, Chris. He'll be back, and this is a great match coming up. Thank you, David.
All right, in our second match, that's Pete McCordick, whom you heard from at the top of our telecast. From Katy, Texas, Houston area, making his seventh TV appearance, and after that 248 to 186 win, Dave Arnold. And first trouble that he's really had today, and he's going to have to try and convert the 6-7-10.
Well, he has to get that ball to the right of the 6-pin. He can drive that 6 over into the 7 and a little extra speed.
He wasn't timid.
You know, it's hard to read Dave Arnold, isn't it, Chris? He just walks around with kind of that stoic, competitive look on his face, where Pete McCordick, if he gets it going, he'll be jumping around, and he's been red hot when he gets it going this week. So let's see what happens in the first couple of shots.
Well, now Pete will have an opportunity to try and shoot this one.
Ooh. Pete McCordick, four-step delivery, inside-out swing. He's going to send that ball just around the first arrow. Doesn't quite catch it all off his fingers. The ball slides by the 2-4-10. Very makeable for Peter.
Year-older, giving it some body English, hoping that, like Arnold now, it's an open frame, score is 8-9. We'll go into the second frame of our second game.
Sounds like the late innings of a baseball game.
Mm-hmm.
two options for a professional bowler or any bowler to play a pair of lanes. One is to go the outside line, as you see Pete McCourty trying to do, and swing the ball wide into the pocket. Excellent for carry. Or you can try what Dave Arnold is doing. He's playing in the heavier oil concentrated in the center of the lane and going a little bit more for control right now. Shot slightly in the favor of Arnold as McCourty is confused.
Luckily, Marks with a spare in the second frame of our second match. Dave Arnold, who's up now and ready to go, won our first game, if you just joined us, over Dave Ferraro, 248-186.
Good break on the 1-2-8 there for McCourty as the head pin strikes the two drives it back into the eight. Arnold knows he's bowling against an opponent who is struggling. One thing you cannot do today, Chris, on with a polyurethane bowling balls that all the players use, and you're rowing on a very high friction surface, is to ease up on your speed. Arnold was a little bit firmer the first game. He eases up. Now he's opened the door for McCourty as he may open twice.
We haven't seen that leave in a long time, Nelson.
Well, it's really like the big five sometimes. With the 10-pin fell out, he missed them all, Chris.
Right. Okay, next on ABC Sports, the Fruit of the Loom Professional Boxing Series continues with another world title bout. Undefeated IBF Junior Flyweight Champion Michael Carbajal in his fifth title defense against challenger Marcos Pacheco. That's live boxing action next, ABC Sports. Trailing by 15. Good recovery. Twenty-fifth television appearance for Pete McCourty. He was the first to win the True Value $100,000 for his perfect game in 1987. Wayne Webb, his opponent, shot a 249 in Torrance, California. Okay. Pete McCourty has had some big moments on tour, but he says he's had some low points, too.
Pete McCourty is playing a line just right around here. He's going to swing it wide, and the ball is going to finish right in the pocket. A very sharp break. Just kicks out to 10.
Way to the right of center. Left lane. Is not quite as loose as he normally is. Seems very tense. Tentative.
Well, Pete is a very strict bowler, Chris, very methodical, as is his opponent, David Arnold. And you get a player like that loose, get him relaxed, get him knowing exactly where the ball is going, and he'll put a lot of balls in the pocket. McCourty has been very close after making adjustments in the first two frames, and there's a lot of frames left in this match as McCourty spares here in the fourth.
Good form, marking with a spare. Okay, friends, 30 years ago, Gene Chandler sang this royal gem.
Your big mistake. Don't let it happen again. Next week on ABC's Pro Bowlers Tour.
Fairlane's open. Baltimore, Maryland, land of the Chesapeake Bay, clams, oysters, the Orioles, and my associate, All-American Tom Gatewood of Notre Dame. Hear, hear. Now Dave Arnold leading by... trailing by 15. Nearly cut it to 5. It's a 4-pin. By the way, I have to a postscript to that comment about one of my heroes, Tom Gatewood. He was football All-American and academic All-American. Double whammy. Now for a spare. Okay, Nelson.
Thank you, Chris Schengel. The man in the semifinal match, the defending champion, Amleto Monacelli. Amleto, both these players are playing a little bit on the outside, and they're struggling. You have a little different strategy?
Well, I think I'm going to play inside. In the practice, I had a good reaction. So I got four balls to see what I'm going to do. But I have a little more hook than the other guys, so I might have a good chance.
He's got a little more hook, a little more confidence. He's a defending champion. He gets four practice balls before his match, Chris. He'll be ready.
Marky Sameto's favorite, and Bleda Monticelli and Dave Arnold. Struggling here, he had a 248 in his victory over Dave Ferraro in the first game with nine strikes. Now he'll try to cover the 3-6. Next week, the Baltimore Herald. It's also the home of jazz pianist Ellis Larkin. Okay. It's our second game. Pete McCordick and Dave Arnold. The winner will meet in Leto Monticelli.
McCordick with not quite a full grip. He's in between what we call a semi-grip between the first and second knuckles. He got lined up the last two frames. Let's see if he can get it going.
That strike coming with a spare up. A few moments ago, we commented that he's had big moments, but he's also had some low points, too.
My biggest thrill on tour was when I won my first tournament. Until you win a tournament, I don't think you get the full respect of your peers, your friends, the people that pull for you. So winning that first tournament was by far my biggest thrill. My disappointments, when you have six second place finishes, those are all disappointing. The biggest disappointment was when I lost to Brian Voss. I tied him in a roll-off for the championship. Lost in a roll-off, it was like losing the tournament twice. I'd also like to say hi to my dad, who's recovering in a hospital in Houston. Get well soon, Dad. We're pulling for you.
And Peter was pulling for that strike to extend his lead to 27. Makes his four-pin. He'll have 89 through the fifth frame. Strike up in the sixth. Working in a 189 pace. Now for Arnold, who's sitting there contemplating what he should do, is he needs to pick his ball speed back up. He was a lot firmer in his first match against Ferraro, and you can't slow down with a urethane bowling ball in your hand and be successful.
And he wishes Father Jack a speedy recovery as well. Pete mentioned Brian Voss. Brian finished eighth, Pete Weber seventh. Bo will have the rundown of the top 24 a little bit later on as we look at Dave Arnold, trailing by 17, spare up, six frame. Now a 310 as he shakes his head.
Well, Chris, I said you have to keep that ball speed up. It's very simple reason is you have high surface frictions, and he's right in this area. He goes right through the center and cuts her into the middle, leaving the 310. And high surface frictions with a urethane bowling ball, urethane lane surfaces, if you throw too slowly, the ball drifts high. And that's exactly what is happening to Arnold right now as he is struggling.
Leaves the three, and it is his third open frame of the match. Now he trails by 30. Big winner in the first game.
There's a man who came out on the tour sponsoring himself, and it cost about $750 to $1,000 a week to stay out here on the tour, has since picked up a backer, and keeps getting better every year. Needs to get his act together right here and give McCordick some competition.
That's done with authority here in our second game. We're at Landmark Lanes in Peoria, Illinois. We'll return.
It's the Fruit of the Loom Professional Boxing Series next on ABC Sports.
With his back to us in the red shirt, he's a 30-pin leader in our second match, Pete McCordick. Katy, Texas, 5'11", 180, 38 years old. Winner today gets $40,000. Okay. Now he's picking up his walking pace even. Has that strike, and he'll be shooting in the eighth coming up.
He's zeroed on the right-hand lane. He's throwing two perfect shots on the right-hand lane, left four pins on the left-hand lane, left lane 37. Let's see what kind of adjustment he makes. He's moved slightly more to the center of the lane. He's going to slide in this area and try to get the ball between the first and second arrows with a little more ball speed, and watch how he holds his follow-through. If this is a good shot, he's going to be tough the rest of the day.
All right, Running it out to his left, Pete McCordick. Two titles.
Watch his follow-through and reaction. One of the best things McCordick does is stays with the shot. See that arm go to target, hold that position. 40-pin lead. He's got Dave Arnold backed up. Eighth frame.
Now with that double, Arnold has cut it back to 30 pins, but very late in our second match.
Okay, for Arnold has a potential 199. Pete McCordick going at a 199 pace, so a few strikes could change this game very quickly. Two frames left. That's McCordick's view from the settee area. Key shot for Arnold.
All right. He did that last night, Bo, to eke into the field of five, didn't he?
You're right, against another Texan, Gary Dickinson. Dickinson threw three strikes, forced Arnold to throw three strikes. They both performed. Arnold made it by one pin. Now another Texan, McCordick, can put Arnold away. Needs a strike here, though.
Gets it.
He's in a position where he can win this match with a mark. A good count, spare a strike, wins the match. He'll go against Monacelli. If he opens, he gives Dave Arnold a chance to win.
At our beginning today, Bo interviewed Pete and the other 300 shooter with the True Value 100,000, Bob Benoit. Bob finished 15th. Pete finished 3rd in his first match this afternoon. Trembling just about as much as he did when he got to the 10th frame of his quest for a perfect game.
Gee, he saw the 6 out of there. That ball hit light, and he almost left a 6-pin. Awesome power on that shot, and he just closes the door on Arnold. Sets up a match where McCordick, the experienced, methodical player, going against 2-time player of the year, Amleto Monacelli. That's enough right there.
He just looked up here at him. Make sure we knew it. He knew it, and that's what counts. So we've, this is our 6th telecast of this 30th anniversary year. We've had 30 different bowlers in the finals. No repeat winners. 5 different ones today. Okay, Pete McCordick will be up next. Bo's tip this week includes Larry Lichtstein as they discuss ball construction. Interesting. Watch and listen.
On today's bowling tip of the week, we're going to deal with the modern bowling ball. And to help me is Player Services Director Larry Lichtstein. Larry, what do we have here today?
Nelson, we have the three-piece ball and the two-piece ball. In the case of the three-piece ball, we have a core, we have a weight block, and we have a cover. This ball here is better used for the outside line, fairly dry lanes. It's been around for about 40 years, this type of construction. In the case of the two-piece ball, we have a core that weighs 5 1/3 pounds, urethane around it approximately 10 2/3 pounds. This ball, dull, is excellent from the inside line, better for the hook player.
All right, Larry, I've got it. The two-piece ball, 16 pounds, is good for the oily lanes in the inside condition, and the 16-pound three-piece ball is good for the dry lanes and the outside conditions. Larry Lichtstein will be back with us next week to show us how to drill sophisticated ball weights.
Dave Arnold defeated Dave Ferraro, 248-186, with 9 strikes. Then in steps Pete McCordick, a Texan. He defeats Arnold with 6 strikes, 215-177. So as we move into our semifinal or third game, it's a defending champion from Venezuela, Amleto Monacelli, against McCordick. Capacity crowd and a big field, Bo.
You're right, Chris. 160 players this week, our standard field. Pretty good game average, 201, 211 to make the top 24. Very demanding. And as the top players came into this position, Dickinson just missed by 1 pin. Weber starting off the season a little bit better. Brian Voss steady every week. Duke, 9th place. Jurek, Berg. Watch that young man in 11th. He's got it all and needs a little more experience. Wiseman, he'll be back home next week. McCune, he was in the championship round at the Flagship Open last week. Ernie Schlegel, the veteran. Bob Benoit, we saw him at the top of the championship round, 300 player. Mark Fay coming back, a tough Chicago, another tough guy there. Jim Pensek kind of working his way out of a slump. Leroy Bornhop from St. Louis area. David Houston finished second in the Flagstaff last week. Robert Lawrence, who finished second in Sacramento. Goble, another good young player on the tour. Jimmy Johnson, Brunswick World Champion a few years back. Watka from Vegas. George Bram III, who made the top five here last year, Chris, and an outstanding match coming up. And the next stop, one of my favorite spots, the Fairlanes.
Okay, the Fairlanes Open in the Baltimore, Maryland area. That's a $150,000 event. And the Florida Open follows that from Winter Haven. That's in the Orlando area. That's a $135,000 tournament. Our next two stops in our 31st year of covering the Professional Bowlers Tour. And in that history, these are two of the champions that we've enjoyed commenting on and watching them perform. Affeder, his 215 to 170, 7 victory. McCordick. Got a little heat on the defending champion, Monticelli. Back-to-back Player of the Year honors. What an incredible performance by this man in 89 and 90.
Much different style than McCordick. McCordick, kind of the standard type style, good solid lift, medium hook. Monticelli, the big hook ball, plays from the way in to way out.
A 10-pin. 30 years old, 5'8", 150 pounds, 11 championships in his 10 years, a member of the Professional Bowlers Association.
A style that we've seen many times in the championship round. Very similar to the great Dick Weber. Opens that hand at the top of the swing, 5-step delivery, good knee bend. He's improved in that area and leaves a 10-pin on that shot.
And Leto has earned $966,166 on the lanes as a pro. Today, the winner gets $40,000, the winner of the True Value Open. This is our semifinal match. He won last year as the top seed. And again, Bo.
That was a much better shot, though. He left the weak 10, but he kept both balls around the pocket. We haven't seen anybody come on in the first two frames and keep the ball around the pocket. A good sign for Monticelli. He's close, and he does have the powerful strike ball. But once again, opponent like McCordick, very methodical, once he's zeroed in, can be very, very tough.
And in this era of varying scores on the lanes, consistent marking can help you a great deal.
Very important. McCordick just had that ball slip off his hand just a little bit, or he carries a 10-pin. Watch this arm swing inside out, how solid he is at the line. I do like that in any player, and McCordick does this as well as anybody. Changes ball to a low, higher surface friction ball, slides across lane, easy.
Pete McCordick, whose first victory, first of two, came in 1988 in Fresno as the top seed. And he did it after he had 6 second place finishes. And Amleto had sort of the same situation, won the Japan Cup after 6 second place finishes. Persistence pays off. All right.
Amleto Monticelli, a good all-around athlete. He was a right forward for the Italian national soccer team when they lived in Italy. Used to weigh almost 200 pounds. Took up running, runs about 20 to 30 miles a week. Now a very slim 150 and one of the best players on the tour.
Again, a single pin spare facing Amleto Monticelli, whose brother Rodolfo is a PBM member as well, but is back in Venezuela, as is his charming wife, Teresa.
I had an opportunity this week, Chris, to cross in the qualifying with Amleto. I got to bowl 18 games with him. He kept all the balls around the pocket. Then when he got hot, really knew where to play the shot, he would put a little extra lift or power with his wrist on the ball. Let's see if he does that in the fourth frame.
Okay, Amleto Monticelli tells us why he skipped last week's flagship open.
My last tournament was in Dallas 2 weeks ago, and I was a little upset about my results. I've been bowling pretty good, but just my bowling result wasn't the one I was expecting to. So I said I'm going to go for a week and just started the winter tour all over. Right. And I went home for a week, came back, and started bowling good again.
Okay. Amleto Monticelli, trailing by two pins, getting his first strike in four frames. We'll be back.
Regional action makes up game one of a doubleheader Sunday on ABC Sports.
Capacity crowd at a great facility, Landmark Recreation Center for the True Value Open. Pete McCordick can increase his lead over Amleto Monticelli by 12 with a strike here.
Okay, Bo.
Thank you, Chris. Our tournament leader, Bruce Hamilton. Bruce, you led this field for 42 games by over 400 pins, one of the largest margins of victory so far in the season. What are your thoughts going into the last game?
Well, I just got to keep the same mentality and just stay focused and think about not the environment, but just doing my job.
You need a win to get in the Firestone. Is that right in the back of your mind?
Oh, I'm trying not to think about that. I just got to put the ball on the mark.
He's got the right attitude, Chris. Make one shot at a time. Let's see how he does. Back to you.
All right. I hit and leaving the nine pin. Charlie Tapp, incidentally, is in the bubble of the Firestone, so if Bruce were to win today, Charlie would be out of the field for next year, at least, or this year, rather, in April of 1992. Okay, Pete McCordick, Texas. Next on ABC Sports, Fruit of the Loom professional boxing continues. IBF junior flyweight champion Michael Carbajal against Marcos Pacheco. That's immediately following us. ABC Sports, live.
Monticelli, in trailing by 11, can cut the lead to one. Fifth frame.
That he does. PBA all-time money winners. There you see Monticelli. He could go over $1 million with a victory today. Second place won't do it.
40,000 on top. Right now, he can take the lead for the first time in the match. Sixth frame, he trails by one pin.
11 championships to his credit. Player of the year twice, 89 and 90. David Ozio, 91. Disappointment.
Doesn't happen very often to Monticelli with this real good wrist action. Look at that open hand and rolls that wrist right underneath the ball. Look at those eyes. Say, Mr. Five Pin, you're supposed to take out the seven. He'll trail by two with a spare.
Semifinal match at the True Value Open, where the trophy is a gold-plated hammer in a case and $40,000. Leading by two, spare up. He, too, wants to get back in the Firestone, Bo.
You're right, Chris. And McCourtick, I've always, always liked his game. He's a likable man on and off the lanes, as is this man, Monticelli. But McCourtick has a game that can match almost any lane conditions. He was a good player on lacquer lane surfaces. He's a good player on the polyurethane lane surfaces, and right now he looks as sharp as I've seen him in a couple of years. He can take a 12-pin lead with a strike in the seventh.
Okay. He defeated Dave Arnold 215-177. He had six strikes in that victory. Well, we'll see what happens. We'll be back soon.
If you didn't see it, that was your big mistake. Don't let it happen again. Next week on ABC's Pro Bowlers Tour.
Two friends, two hosts. On the left, Jerry Thompson, merchandising manager of True Value Hardware. And on the right, G. Raymond Becker, proprietor of Landmark Recreation Center. And Mr. Peoria. Along, of course, with the mayor, James Maloof.
Monticelli trailing by 12 pins, seventh frame. He's going at a 207 pace. McCourtick at a 219 pace. A lot of action left. Semifinal game.
Longest follow through yet. The longest held follow through by Monticelli. Look,
Chris,
at it.
I agree with you. He has disciplined his game. A little love tap from the 6-pin on the 10. And there's a lot of power players on the tour. There's predominance of power players. But Monticelli is one of the power players, has made the turn with discipline. He holds his follow-through, and you'll watch as he plays the lane here. He starts here. He'll walk here. He'll play between the second and third arrows. But watch that finish at the line. Very disciplined.
Wow. It didn't look like they would, but they did.
Watch the 2-pin, the third pin on the left-hand part of your screen. Watch the job it does. It goes to the sideboard, pops out the 4, gets a love tap on the 9. We have a match. Only 2-pin difference, 8th frame.
Double up for McCourtick. I hit and he has left the 3-6-10.
Watching McCourtick for 42 games this week. Only one problem he has is he softens up a shot every once in a while and aims it. He's got that ball breaking very sharply to the pocket. Has to keep the speed up. We saw Arnold have trouble start slowing down. Now McCourtick, even if he makes a spare, will trail Monticelli by 1 pin, 9th frame coming up.
Nearly stuck at the line, and the shot was pulled, as you could see. Ooh, he was lucky.
Well, Peter is putting that shot behind him. Remember, all you have to do is touch him or a spare. It doesn't take any power for spares, and McCourtick proves that point.
It was a Valentine's Day hit, wasn't it? 1 pin. Trailing now. 9th frame. Leaving a 3.
2 shots high, 1 in the 8th, 1 in the 9th. McCourtick just softened up a little bit. He'll grab a lower surface friction ball, go over the third arrow from the right-hand channel, knock off the 3-pin, and he'll trail by 2.
Gives it that long, dirty look, and I don't blame him.
Monticelli can shut out McCourtick if he can strike in the 9th and 10th frames in a good count. If he doesn't, the match will go to the 10th.
Double up. Leads by 12.
I once described Monticelli's release as it looks like somebody trying to start their lawnmower on a summer day, and that time he started at full throttle. He caught it all with that great wrist action through the 5-pin into the 7. Right now he is in a position to shut out that man, Pete McCourtick.
You still do it that way? Start your mower with a... Don't you have a battery operated? Come on, Bo.
True Value has the battery operated.
I know, Lawn Chiefs. No! another long and held follow-through. Stylish. Sad for him, though.
An old saying, maintain your form under pressure. And it's so true for both of these players. Monacelli doing it the best right now, the defending champion. Just a good count, five pins, will allow him to go against the man who dominated the field, Bruce Hamilton, in the championship game.
Defending champion here at Landmark Lanes in Peoria, Illinois. So, Pete McCordick, really disappointed, looked so good, defeated Arnold in the previous match, and was hoping to go all the way and cop that $40,000 first prize. He'll have to settle for $12,500. And when they go into that championship match, the two will be bowling for $62,000. A non-winner, Bruce Hamilton, against the 11-time champion at whom you're looking, Amleto Monacelli. ABC Sports presentation of the Professional Bowlers Tour will return after this message and a word from our ABC sponsors.
Ever wonder why you...
Ship. Back to you now, Chris.
In the 11th True Value Open at Landmark Lanes, in the first match, Dave Arnold defeated Dave Ferraro 248-186. Arnold's next opponent was Pete McCordick. Pete defeated him 215-177. And then Pete McCordick met Amleto Monacelli. Final score, big game, best of the day, 247 to Pete's 223. And now, Bruce Hamilton and Amleto Monacelli will bowl for their $40,000 first prize. Here's Nick Mermando, who is president of the National Bowling Hall of Fame and Museum in St. Louis, where a week from Sunday, the third annual salute to champions. One individual, two corporations to be saluted. The ABC PBA Hall of Famer Dick Weber, with 31 titles, gets a big award. Knight Ritter Incorporated Newspapers and Bridgestone Firestone. That is a week from Sunday in St. Louis. Salute to champions. Hope you make it. Okay.
Hey, Pete. Yeah, Chris. Pete McCordick had a good week. And mm-hmm. Peter, I thought when you got by Dave Arnold that definitely you'd go ahead and win the tournament. And you actually had Monacelli slightly on the ropes. What happened?
Out of the last commercial break, I think I just got a little soft on the shots. A little less ball hooked, a little too sharp two times in a row. So it's my fault. I just hadn't been on TV in a while. But I think I'll be back pretty soon again.
That Southern Desk action is very tough. Pick up winner very quickly for me between Monacelli and Hamilton.
Well, Amleto didn't miss a pocket. I think you have to go with Amleto right now.
Chris, a good match coming up.
Yes, and Pete, congratulations, 12-5. There will be more in the future for our Houston, Texas friend. Tomorrow, Domino's Pizza College Basketball presents a regional doubleheader. In Game 1, most of you will see the number one ranked defending national champion, Duke Blue Devils, against North Carolina State, plus Kansas State at Oklahoma or Southern Miss at Memphis State. Then Game 2 follows as Louisville meets DePaul. Out west, Washington State faces Arizona State, or in the south, it's Georgia at Texas. Tomorrow, live on ABC Sports. Here's the handshake for $62,000. Here's the True Value head-to-head match for the Hammer Trophy and the title. Defending champion Amleto Monacelli, first on the left lane. Big strike.
This man came out of nowhere. Everybody thought he would falter in the top 24. And then when he got through the first day of play, Thursday night he was leading, and on Friday he just extended his lead.
Oh, no. Unfair. 7-10 for this 31-year-old professional who was sixth last week at the Flagship Open.
7-10 split. Not much you can do about it. He keeps the ball wide. And here's what Roth did it, but Roth has a lot of speed as you see him bounce the 10-pin out. Happened in 1980. and somebody reacting to the monitor. Here's Arnold up there. I think, Chris, he'll just try to knock the 10 out and keep his stroke. Just forget the bad break. This kid has a really good demeanor on the lanes, and he doesn't come unglued.
A good temperament of Seattle, Washington product. 31-year-old, 5'10", 160 pounds, a guy who has bicycled across the United States twice. 40,000 miles. He's been Nova Scotia, Atlanta, and back. He's been everywhere.
Whew.
Good wheels.
You bet. And that's what it takes to bowl well. Good legs.
Now Amlodo Monacelli opened with a strike. He'll be shooting on the right lane.
Monacelli with 17 perfect games on the PBA Tour and 15 games in South America in Venezuela, where they have basically no sanctioning. They just put the leagues together and go. So 32 perfect games in his career.
There's a double by Monacelli. This week there was not one 300 game. Last year there were 12.
Well, the scoring environment has changed a little bit by the PBA lane maintenance crew. We've said it week after week that they have a number of different lane conditioning procedures. This week they had a, what I would say, very competitive shot for 2 days, and there were no 300s. McCordick had the high game at 298. Monacelli, the full grip, extends that index finger, and he kind of keys off it. Look at the pressure on the tip of the index finger. Third frame. He has two in a row.
Two pin. And by the way, the low game of this week was 109, and I will not mention his name.
All right.
Because I can feel for him.
It'll happen to any touring
yes.
pro sooner or later. And $200,000 eludes the Monacelli treasury as he had the last chance for anybody to bowl a perfect game today. Now the title's at stake. Chris, remember the one of the greatest players of all time, Ned Day?
Oh, yes.
And the type of release and role he had. See if you don't see that in Bruce Hamilton.
Okay.
The drop thumb, the high roll between the thumb and finger holes.
Oh, there. Audible proof, too, going down the lane, right?
You bet. Here's the style. Normal high swing. See that thumb dropping under? Almost what we call a full roller. The ball rolls just on the edge of the thumb hole and the finger hole. And check out the action on the 10. You gotta like it. He's right back in the match. He can make it all even with a strike in the fourth.
Okay. Marking with those big strikes in this championship game for the True Value Open. We'll be back. Open championship game. Here it is. Last year's winner, Amlodo Monacelli. We're all even. He's going against Bruce Hamilton of Seattle. Tit for tat.
You bet, except for it happens for Monacelli in the fourth frame, and it's going to cost him a little bit more than it cost Hamilton, who had the same type of hit on the same lane, the swishing 7-10, in the first frame. Now Monacelli will just try to knock off the 10-pin and go back to his work.
All right.
It's a pin thrown away, partner.
Yes. Disgust. So now he'll have to try and come back on the left lane. Remember, he's going against Bruce Hamilton, who has yet to win his first PBA titles. He has four regional titles in the Northwest. Looking away, doesn't watch his opponent. Now he may be sneaking a peek. 3-6-10.
Two excellent athletes. Monacelli runs as much as 15 miles a day, Chris. And Bruce Hamilton, you said, is a bicyclist, but he also trained for the Ironman, the triathlon. And he's run a 3:18 marathon in the last couple of years. So you know the guy's in very, very top shape. These guys are excellent athletes.
Well, I want to congratulate you on finishing 44th.
Nice paycheck, $1,250. Good prize money.
Twice as much as you're getting today. Okay. This is our title game. Winner will get 40. Runner-up 22, Pete McCordick, finished at 12-5.
See if we can hear that ball hitting the thumb hole and the finger holes. That's the track of the ball as it rolls down the lane for Bruce Hamilton.
Nelson.
Almost from the get-go, Chris. He releases the ball a little bit too early. He leaves the 2-8-10. When you release it early, the ball doesn't break as much as you need. He needs to get the ball over in the 2-8 zone to make this spare. You see the ball sliding by. Just go for the two. Remember, he had a double up. Every pin's worth two on the scoreboard at this point.
Bruce Hamilton says there was a good reason why he didn't become a PBA rookie until age 29.
Well, quite frankly, I really wasn't good enough when I was younger. You know, these guys are pretty good. And you can't come out here and just expect to beat them. You got to get something under your belt, and I wanted to establish a career before I came out and tried to bowl.
He's a software consultant.
Trailing by one as he went into that frame, and that now sets him up for the next time he bowls. Meanwhile, Monticelli, leading by one, has a spare up in this title game. Sixth frame. Competition all of us enjoy, and I know you as viewers do, and we've had a lot of it in the 30 years that we've completed. Now we're in our 31st year of PBT covering on ABC. Don't forget, boxing follows. Through the Loom Boxing Series, Carbajal and Pacheco. Is a little mechanical problem that's happening now. Corrected.
Young player here just holding a piece of like adhesive tape in his hand to keep his hand nice and dry.
Wanted that 11 pin lead, and what does he get? 4-7-10.
Four, seven, ten, a tough shot for Monticelli. Guy has to get the ball to the right of the left of the four pin and drive it into the 10. Really a tough shot.
His name, first ever telecast.
Chance to extend his lead to 21 as Monticelli is faltering here. Watch the angle that this young man's playing. He's playing the biggest hook ball of any of the players, going into the 1-3 pocket. Doesn't quite carry out the 10 pin.
Like that green or turquoise shirt, this is a cool customer, Bo.
You bet, Chris, and very cerebral player, as Monticelli. Monticelli really doesn't worry too much about his opponent. He's just trying to figure out what he has to do on the lanes. Both players, eighth frame.
Beautifully done. In the pressure stages of this championship match, difference of 18,000, winning or finishing second here. 40 and 22 to the runner-up.
Right now, Monacelli going at a 183 pace, Hamilton 194. The championship's up for grabs. Okay, take a look at Bruce Hamilton. What we thought was adhesive tape earlier is just a piece of paper he pulls out of his pocket, obviously reading a reminder on what he must do mentally or physically to make the best shot he can. Monacelli can cut the lead to one pin, ninth frame.
That's the one pin that plagued him. A seven.
Monacelli needed that shot. Mm. Throws the five over in front of the seven. Look at that concentration, the good wrist action, and he knows he's got everything he can get on it. Disappointed. Trails by 11. Now, whatever it says on that piece of paper, Chris Schenkel, he must need it right now because you don't want to give Monacelli a chance in the 10th frame to get up there and beat you, and a strike right here would put Monacelli on the ropes, 9th frame.
Was there a St. Louis bowler that used to do that? Ray Bluth?
Ray Bluth used to have little reminders all the time, and just like this young man is using something to remind him in between frames. We'll definitely find out what that is if he wins the championship here and it works for him. Let's see what he can do. A strike would lock up his first PBA title and put him in the Firestone Tournament of Champions, the last stop on the PBA Winter Tour.
Ballard marking the strikes here today. And I know our regular scorer is just out of the hospital. Butch Soper enjoyed this action here as he's watching from California. So, Charlie Tapp is out of the Firestone and Bruce Hamilton is in.
New winners almost every week this year. A lot of good young players, as you mentioned earlier, Chris. 30 players we've seen in the 6 weeks. Here's another new champion. Hamilton looks awfully sharp, has a potential 224. He has defeated Monacelli.
Oh, yes. 5 feet 10, 160 pounds. Getting that first title, a big one, at the Trouvalle. He asked if it was over, if he had clinched it. And when he was reminded, look at that victor smile. Ooh, what a big day for the bicyclist from Seattle. Okay, he's won $40,000 of that total purse, true value. Bruce Hamilton, you'll see him in a few moments. We'll be back.
I'll take the special.
I'll take the special.
Oh. Of the True Value Open, 11th time here at Landmark Lanes. $40,000, a first-time winner, Bruce Hamilton. And here he is. 224 to 180. Congratulations.
Oh, thank you kindly. I'd like to speak for all the bowlers and thank True Value for their long-standing support of the PBA. And I'd also like to give my personal thanks to Ron Hoppe for all he's done for me.
And who's Ron Hoppe?
He's my coach. He taught me how to bowl.
All right. Here's a man that teaches a lot of people how to bowl. A two-time player of the year. Tough day today, Amleto.
Well, I guess I did my best. Bruce bowled great, and we got both bad breaks, and but he performed really well. I'm happy the way I performed too. Thanks.
You'll be back.
Yes. Thank you. I want to thank True Value for sponsoring us, for supporting us every year. Thank you.
Pride and Joy South American. We love him here.
Okay, Jerry Thompson, Merchandise Director of True Value, and G. Raymond Becker, proprietor here, with a beautiful hammer and a check.
Bruce, on behalf of the True Value stores across the country, I want to present this beautiful trophy to you. You earned it. Oh. Congratulations.
Thank you kindly.
Bruce, here's your beautiful check, $40,000. You want to meet me afterwards? We might invest it.
We can talk.
The bicyclist is now a bowling champion.
Oh, it feels good, too. I'm quite pleased. I was so focused on what I was doing, I didn't even know it was a 10th frame. I got up there, I thought I was bowling the 8th frame.
Yes, we saw that, but again, congratulations. Bruce Hamilton of Seattle, Washington. And fortunately, Bruce, I've been just given, this is rare in television, an additional 30 seconds. Oh. Anything else you'd like to add for the Northwest?
Well, I'd just like to thank all the fans at home. They've really been behind me. There's been a lot of people who've helped me. Terry and Dean at Pro Shops Unlimited, thank you very much. Again, Ron Hoppe, hey, you taught me how to bowl. I can't tell you how much I appreciate it.
And Jerry and Ray, I can't tell you how much you've added to the Professional Bowlers Tour. Nice going, everyone. See you later, next week.
Next, the Fruit of the Loom Professional Boxing Series follows with a world championship bout. Olympic medalist Michael Carbajal puts his perfect record and world title on the line live. The Pro Bowlers Tour has been brought to you by True Value. Got a tough job to do? You can do it with True Value Hardware Stores. By Firestone Tire, official sponsor of the U.S. Olympic team. And by Menin. There's no better way to face the day than with Speed Stick by Menin. This has been a presentation of ABC Sports, recognized around the world as the leader in sports television.